hear him.
Graduates, parents, faculty, and guests. As we look back on our past 11 years of education, we acknowledge all of our hard work and accomplishments. Yet we realize that this is only the beginning of the rest of our lives. We have reached a turning point, where for some it will be the end of a formal education, and they will move out into the workforce, while for others it is simply a step in the process of a continuing education. Whichever avenue we choose to pursue, there will be rewards to gain, challenges to face, and opportunities to encounter. We must remember that we are the future of this world, and in so remembering, we must seek to develop new ideas, goals, and aspirations to sustain our place in society. This past year has been
a time of preparation
as we embark on this lifelong journey. We must hold on to our memories and the lessons we have learned, for they are the foundations of our future. We must cherish yesterday, live today, and reach for tomorrow. Thank you.
I am still.
what this class has endured. There's nothing new in saying that over the years at BHS, hard work, perseverance, and dedication got us where we are today. Aside from our studies, the last 4 years brought with it many changes and many challenges. But controversy is good, for this is how we learn that life is not perfect. Otherwise, it wouldn't be life. Yes, some of us survived senioritis, a decreased motivation in studies, and no, our high school career was not perfect, but neither is life. And you may ask yourselves, what does she know about life? She's only just beginning to live. I know that life is filled of wonderful experiences and difficult situations. Someone once told me that when we meet a challenge, we just have to take a deep breath and take it one step at a time. If you think you have it bad, the person sitting next to you might probably have a probably bigger dilemma. So all right, let's see, are we ready to graduate? First, do we cherish our yesterday? Don't forget the sweaty palms of our hands on the first day of school, the sports practices, the test finals, the band competition, and of course, our traditional grand social, the prom. As a class, we've been through good and bad, and I'm pretty sure we won't forget each other's faces. I knew I wouldn't want to leave BHS the minute I walked through those doors. But it's time to move on. Second, are we living today? Let us enjoy ourselves tonight. Let us savor the glory of our victory, for today, the class of 2007 graduates. Third, let us reach for tomorrow, for we will meet our goals and become nurses, teachers, doctors, architects, and more. We know that in the future, we will do this all over again with our children. Time flies, and all beginnings come to an end. I still can't believe I'm graduating right now. Right here, today, right now, our high school journey is over, but a new beginning awaits us. So I'm not going to end with a traditional Emerson quote, but I am going to say what Joshua J. Marine once said. He said, challenges are what make life interesting. Overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. So to the class of 08, 09, and 10, I say cherish yesterday, live today, and reach for tomorrow. Congratulations and good luck to the class of 2007.
We were moving mountains long before we knew. embark on a new time in our lives, I am reminded of the words of Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. You are the guy who will decide where to go. This fits very well with our class motto, cherish yesterday, live today, reach for tomorrow. Cherish yesterday. At graduation, many people cry, but again, the very wise Dr. Seuss reminds us, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. Graduation happened, but friendships were formed, memories were made, and relationships were molded. One thing we must always remember is that we are members of the BHS class of 2007. Whether Katie Branch is breaking bones or running, both of which she does a lot, Megan Crawford is finding out about cousins she never knew she had, Brandon Cross and Iris Wilcox are performing on the dance floor, or Town and Alex are making us all feel a little less intelligent, we have the memories of high school stuck in our minds. We can all remember sitting in school in late June with no air conditioning, counting down the days until school is out. Well, class of 2007, school's out! Memories of the past 4 years include everything from getting out of school on a half day because it was too hot to be in the building, changing the block scheduling, and changing the uniforms. We may not have enjoyed all the changes, but we have enjoyed the time we spent with each other. Tiana and I were in Sweden earlier this year, and we were discussing how other classes seem divided, but in the class of 2007, everyone seems to know each other, and most people seem to get along. Live today. Advice that is too often given is live every day like it's your last. Today is the last day of our lives in high school, but tomorrow is the first day in our real world. Carpe diem, seize the day. Today is that day. We have worked for 13 years and finally reached graduation. Reach for tomorrow. High school has been just a building block towards the rest of our lives. After all the diplomas are given and we all go our separate ways, some may go on to pursue higher education or different careers, but we must always remember that we are members of the BHS class 2007. We must never let anyone keep us away from our dreams. We must keep reaching for the next rung on the ladder to success. I leave you forever with the quotes of two very famous women. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "The purpose of life is to live it, to taste experience to the utmost, to reach out eagerly and without fear for newer and richer experiences." And the very wise Mabel Simmons, also known as Medea, said, "Please do it! I want to see you do it!" Cherish yesterday, live today, reach for tomorrow. Oh, and guess what? We made it! Would my fellow class officers please join me for a special presentation?
Small token of our appreciation. We thank you very much. Can Mr. Ahmed come up, please? On behalf of the class of 2007, we would like to present this to you. Can Ms. Giorgio join us up here?
Mr. Lynch, can you please come down, please? Thank you very much for all your help and support. Ms. Bilderback, could you please come up here? Ms. Bilderback, we just want to say thank you for coming back to share this very special day with us, and thank you for all you did for us.
Ms. Birdfield, can you come up here, please? Ms. Birdfield, we just wanted to thank you, and I wanted to do this because, you know, you've known me since I was really little. You've changed my diapers and everything. So, Ms. Birdfield, thank you very much for everything you've done.
And many ideas that each of us have in mind for our futures. Yet, there never seemed to be enough hours in the day to finish all the necessary things that needed to be done. We did what we had to do and went for our goals and dreams. We stuck together when others doubted us. We proved to the people that didn't believe in us that when you put your mind to something, you can reach for the stars and bring down the moon. Graduation is finally here, and tonight is the last time we, the class of 2007, will be together as one. Tomorrow, we might never see each other again, which is why we must cherish every minute in life. We thank all the people who helped us along the way. We will never forget Bridgeton High School, because this school was our school. I believe the class motto says it best. Cherish yesterday, live today, and reach for tomorrow. Bridgeton High School is and forever will be in our hearts.
Thank you. haters laugh, outweigh the bad. Oh, outweigh the bad. I thought we gained to see forever, but forever's gone away. Oh, it's so hard to say goodbye.
I don't know
where this road
is gonna lead.
All I know is where we've been.
Do not forget to live protect you for life. Every pain, I mean... Just as you have chosen the steps that have led you here today, I know you will choose the right steps to lead you into your future. As this graduation ceremony draws to a close, I would like to remind the class of 2007 not to think of this as the end of high school, but as a new phase of life. As you enter into your various endeavors, allow nothing to hold you back. Think about what you have accomplished, what you are still accomplishing, and the many things that you can accomplish. So, as you think about what the future holds for you, remember where you have come from, be thankful for where you are, and strive for where you want to be. Through cherishing yesterday, living today, and reaching for tomorrow, we are destined to become the future leaders of America that our families, friends, teachers, and community have been preparing us to be. Once again, congratulations, graduates, and thank you all for helping me to cherish yesterday, live today, and reach for tomorrow.
Over here. You need to leave now. It's an emergency. Anthony Pierce.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, graduates, parents, friends, relatives, VHS staff. I am honored to welcome you to the graduation ceremony for the Grisham High School class of 2007. I am proud to present to you the students who have fulfilled the requirements for graduation that have been established by our school district and the state of New Jersey. Will the officers for the class of 2007 please stand to be recognized as I call your name? President Rosemary Garcia. Vice President Timothy Zoryak. Adesia Abdus-Salam. Treasurer, Tiana Wright. Historian, Marley Henestrosa. I'm also pleased and so very proud to introduce our two valedictorians for the class of 2007, Tiana Wright and Alex Speaker. Salutatorian Rosemary Garcia. I would now like to recognize those students who are graduating with specific honor status as designated by the color cords that they are wearing. I would ask that those groups of students stand when recognized and remain standing until everyone has been acknowledged. The audience should note that the distinguished scholars are recognized by a white cord. The meritorious scholars by the maroon cord. The National Honor Society members are wearing the gold cord. Students wearing the blue cord are recipients of a merit award. Yeah. course are graduates of the adult high school. It is with great honor that I present these students before you as the newest graduating class from Bristol High School. Victor Hugo once said, "There is nothing like a dream to create the future." I believe that as children and young adults, our dreams and experiences play a vital role in shaping our future. We envision who we are and where we want to be, where we want to go, and what we want to do when we get there. Through our dreams, we give life to our hopes, our personal desires, our educational and vocational aspirations, our 1, 5, and 10-year plans. Through endless hours of daydreaming, we nurture, revise, and expand the plan. For many of us, the plan is simple. We seem to know instinctively where our future lies. We simply follow family traditions and we recognize our own unique talents and skills and are automatically drawn to careers that promote areas of interest. For these young people, the roadmap is easy. For the rest, however, the roadmap is much more difficult to maneuver. It is also because of our dreams that we set goals and for many of us actually formulate action plans to ensure that we accomplish those goals. I'd like for all of you, raise your hand if you have gone so far as to write down your goals on paper so that you could refer to them at a later date, so that you could keep yourself on track, and so that you would never forget your dreams. It's the how we go about achieving our goals, on the other hand, that usually causes us the most concern. There are lots of twists and turns, setbacks, drawbacks, stop signs, and red lights. Every so often, these young people might even have to stop in the middle of the road, make a U-turn, go back a few blocks, and start all over again. But as Langston Hughes reminds us, hold fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken-winged bird that cannot fly. The young people gathered here tonight have also dreamed those dreams. Their participation in the ceremony this evening confirms the fact that they too realize that education is the first step to a successful financial future in this ever-growing global economy. They recognize that receiving a high school diploma is just the first step in fulfilling their dreams. They continue to revise the plan and they continue to dream. Over the years, I've had the unique opportunity to have had an ongoing dialogue with many of these young people. I have listened to their hopes and dreams and their plans for the future. I am proud to announce that you are looking at the next generation of community leaders, teachers, doctors, nurses, engineers, auto mechanics, and the list goes on. I am extremely proud of each and every one of them. Finally, I would like to end with a quote from Mark Twain, who summarizes my thoughts so eloquently. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bow lines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade wind in your sails, explore, dream, and discover. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you the class of 2007. Everyone in the audience to remain seated for the recessional. All graduates will return to the high school lobby to pick up their diplomas. Parents can meet them in front of the lobby area. For safety reasons, I'm asking that you refrain from driving your car on the driveway in front of the school. I would also ask that you refrain from walking on the track. Our two academy principals, Ms. Dorian Giorgio and Mr. Azim Ahmad, will also assist with the distributing of diplomas. I would now like to present our mayor, Mr. James Begley, Councilwoman Celeste Riley, and Councilman Albert Kelly and Bill Spence, who will make special presentations to the valedictorians and salutatorians.
Fantasy. I've got a full audience, all your attention, and a microphone. I want to say thank you for having us. I'm not going to do the presentation tonight, but I have three council people that will. I just want to say thank you for the invite, and I wish all the class of 2007 the best of luck in the future.
Again, I'm Celeste Riley, and I want to say congratulations to the class of 2007. I'm very impressed. So I have a resolution here for, if I can read it, when it will blow away. Resolution number 279-06. Resolution of the City Council of the City of Bridgeton honoring Alex Lee Cooper. Whereas Alex Lee Cooper has brought honor to his family, school, and community upon being named valedictorian of the Bridgeton High School class of 2007, and whereas Alex Lee Cooper has earned distinction being a member of the National Honor Society and Leo's Club and played varsity tennis and served as captain of the tennis team, and whereas Alex Lee Cooper has received academic honors, excellence awards, the Edward J. Blaustein Award, and the Rotary Youth Leadership Award, now therefore be it resolved by the Mayor and City Council of the City of Bridgeton that Alex Lee Cooper be commended on achieving the distinction of valedictorian, and may his future be filled with the best of everything in life that life has to offer. Mr. Cooper.
Present this resolution to a young lady that certainly has showed us some courage and perseverance tonight. More so than I could have at your age, that's for sure. This is a resolution of the City Council of the City of Bridgeton honoring Tiona LaFawn Wright. Whereas Tiona LaFawn Wright has brought honor to her family, school, and community upon being designated valedictorian of the 2000 graduating class of Bridgeton High School. And whereas Tiona LaFawn Wright has received many, she's my new adopted daughter. Tiona LaFawn Wright participated in various class activities, including the cheerleader, JV softball, and field hockey, style squads, senior mentor, and peer mediator. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Mayor and the City Council of the City of Bridgeton that LaFawn Wright be accorded the congratulations of her community through the expression of great pride in her accomplishments, with hope that she will realize happiness, fulfillment, and the best of everything life has to offer. Adopted at a regular meeting of the City Council of the City of Bridgeton held on 5 day of June 2007.
This is a resolution of the City Council honoring Rosemary Garcia. The resolution reads as follows. Whereas Rosemary Garcia has brought honor to her family, school, and community upon being named salutatorian of the Bridgeton High School class of 2007. Whereas Rosemary Garcia has earned distinction being a member of the student government, hosts a select choir, honor society, Latin club, as well as playing JV and varsity soccer, participated in student government as class president for the last 4 years. And whereas Rosemary Garcia has received honors including Rotary Youth Leadership Award, Armanda Latino Incorporated Youth Award. Now therefore be it resolved by the mayor and city council, the city of Bridgeton, that Rosemary Garcia be commended for achieving the distinction of salutatorian, and may her future be filled with the best of everything life has to offer. Council President Nick Salvatore, approved by Mayor James Begley, June 5th, 2007. Rosemary Garcia.
Each year to certify that the students seated before you today have satisfied all the requirements of the New Jersey State Board of Education and the Bridgeton Board of Education. This is possible tonight because of those of you seated in the audience. We all know that a child's first education begins at home. Without you, these students would not be here tonight. In addition to those of you in the audience, there are many other people that have had a part in these young men and women's education. Many of them are with us here tonight. We have members of the Bridgeton Board of Education, Mr. Jonathan Griffin, Mr. Willie Tukes, Mr. Curtis Edwards, Ms. Marie Bernstein, Mr. Kenneth Smithbay. I thank you for your undevoted time, effort, and everything you do for these children. You are truly devoted to the goodwill and good education of the students of the Bridgeton Public Schools. It is my primary responsibility here to say to you that the students here have satisfied all the aforementioned requirements and can now call Bridgeton High School their alma mater. Congratulations. Ms. Delacuilla, our board president, Mr. Jack Cerenzi, is evidence that education continues. He himself is receiving a diploma tonight, and therefore he could not be with us. And so, because he is not here, I will present to you, Ms. Delacuilla, as a representative of the Board of Education, the class of 2007.
Sorry. On behalf of the Bridgeton Board of Education, it is my pleasure to present this diploma to the class president of 2007 and our salutatorian, Rosemary Garcia. Congratulations.
It is an honor to receive this right here on behalf of the entire class of 2007.
Thank you. previous
Charles Bard.
James Octavian Cox.
Jr.
Candace Trinette Hill.
Thank you.
Roland Pierce Jr. Jr.
Kenneth Ross.
Joseph Carl Renninger Jr.
Sylvia Royster.
Javier Reyes.
Shayna W. Russell.
Michael Jack Regenis.
Carlita Lynn Santos.
Alexander Russell Jr.
Stephanie Marie
Schultz. Rosario A. Salgado.
Ernesto Darius Smith.
Frances Waleska Tawara Portillo.
Justin Tyler Smith.
Kelly Lynn Thompson. Anita Thompson.
Timothy Michael Smith. Roger Allen Fittimore Jr.
Desiree Iris Torres.
Jonathan W. Starr.
Maria de Jesus Torres Velasquez.
Jermaine J. Stocks.
Matthew String.
Haley Janine White.
Aaron M. Swain.
Danaya Lily Wilson.
Lauren F. Bart the Fifth.
Iris Marie Wolfa.
Jose Luis Torres.
Alicia Williams.
Rafael Granado.
Ashley Denise Wallace. And Phoebe
Kenneth J. Wilson.
Let's go! the song in the break of the 90s. Of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about to do to see the new romance? Give me a sauce of a mix, and if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And then with the suckers of the past, to adjust the face and let the outline lies. Pop in my CD and let me run around and put your fire on dreams. And look up, cause it's summertime.